3, 2, we are live. Good morning, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the wonderful world of the Jet Jams. What's up, guys? How's it going? It's a live show, Jet Stream, whatever you guys want to call it. I'm here. I'm gonna be doing a show. It's gonna be an amazing show. And what are we doing today? We got a lot of stuff planned, but we're getting off on a little rocky start because I have a special guest who's not here at the moment. Let me know if you guys can hear me okay. As always, that's appreciated. I see a couple of you guys here already joining. My phone's a little dim, but I can see you guys' comments. It says here we have Laurie Nurmi, Riku X. Oh, snap. We don't want that. They think that I forgot about this stream. No, I did not forget about this stream. I didn't forget. Lily Haas, good. Good to see you. Laurie Numi, Mobius. Whoop, what's up? Here I am. So I just started the show without John. We actually scheduled for 10, but he said he needed a minute. So I gave him a minute. But the show has to start because I don't want you guys to sit and wait. Backup plan. Let's try to do let's do a little bit of Q&A because I missed a couple people's questions from the last show and I feel really bad about it. So I will answer your questions from the last show. Let's see here. Let me just share my screen so you can see what I'm looking at. Okay. Right. And I will draw as well if I have to, but I'm on my desktop, so it might be too slow. Hopefully it's not too slow. Let's see here. I'm going to share the screen. Okay. Share the screen. Mm-hmm. Just so that you guys can see the questions. Screen one, screen two, screen two, the hangout. Screen two, screen one, okay. Share. Wow. Okay, so from the last stream, I missed these questions. And I'm sorry because I was so just like focused on the drawing. I missed your questions totally. And you guys followed my instructions, which I appreciate so much. It's easier to see your guys' question when I see question. If you guys start with question and then your question, then I can see it. So Fimox asks, what's your usual streaming hours, Jet? It's past midnight here, so I've got to go soon. It's a very, very good question. Usually I stream for about 2 hours, but if you're wondering what time I stream or when I stream, they're pretty random most of the time, but I'm looking to stream at least once on Monday and maybe on a Friday. But Fridays is usually a regular show where I actually teach and give a tutorial out. If my schedule's booked and like I'm working a lot of stuff, then I'll just do a stream because it's easier to just stream than edit and film an actual tutorial. So if you guys want to get updated on what time the stream is, just follow my Art of Jetty Jet show. Hold on, let me see. And here's you guys' comments right there. There you guys are. There you are. Hold on a sec. Let me pull up my Art of the Jetty Jet real quick. It's no longer Art of Jetty Jet. I've streamlined all of my social media into one name, and that is the Art of Jetty Jet. So if you type in the Jetty Jet Show. If you go to the Jetty Jet Show on anything on the internet, it'll just pop up my social. Yeah. So if you search in the Jetty Jet Show on Facebook, then you will get this page. And I usually post up here also on my Instagram. So that's a good question. John needs 5 minutes to finish something. He's so busy. He's such a busy guy. It's cool. It's cool, John. Cool. I got it. I'm about to draw something. So yeah, that's question number one. Number two, Gnarnar asks, Gnarnar head, I'm sorry. Question, is it true that you once outboxed a Hitmonchan? Hitmonchan the Pokemon? I have not. I have not outboxed a Hitmonchan. Nope. Can't say that I have. I'd probably get knocked out by one of those guys. Jimmy Sin, question. How would you deal with an artsy-fartsy teacher who would rather force you to do completely self-indulged assignments and making us spill out our life story? How would I deal with that artsy-fartsy teacher? I had pretty long list. I have a couple of quote-unquote bad teachers in my time, in my career. Matter of fact, my high school teacher was pretty discriminatory, pretty mean to me. I just did it, especially I was a freshman. So I was freshman in high school, and as a young artist or young person in general, it's just, you know, you just obey authority, and I just did it, dealt with it. It was pretty difficult, but you know, try to be yourself. You know, if it starts getting in the way, like of your if like you're stressing about it too much, then you should maybe take the teacher aside and talk to the person and say, and give them your thoughts, you know, give them your 1-2 Hitmonchans. But if it's not something that you like dealing with day and night, like in your sleep, then you don't have to worry about it. I think you just, you know, they're not going to be in your life forever. And, you know, they're just lonely because they're lonely and they feel like picking on kids. Anyways, what else we have here? I got this message here. It says, it's okay. That's all I got. The last message is on my phone. There we go. Oh, there you go. Welcome to the Jetty chat box. All right. What are you going to do today? What am I going to do? Well, I had a special guest, but he needs a couple minutes. More. So I'm going to try to draw something. Let's see if my computer can handle this today. I wonder what time it is for you guys. For me, it is morning. And normally this time was my cartoon morning time. So if you guys are in America and on the West Coast, and it's Saturday morning cartoons, what's better than skipping your cartoons and watching the Jetty Jet show? Nothing in the world of Carmen San Diego. Okay, so am I screen sharing? It says I'm screen sharing. Okay, so let me know if you guys can see my screen share. Present. It says I'm screen sharing. Okay, yours is. Okay. All right. Okay, check out this lag there. That's what I deal with. All right. Turn this off here. Let's see if I can. Okay. Anyone else just like saying Jetty Jet as much as me? It's weird. I just decided with that name just like randomly and kind of just stuck. Kind of just stuck, didn't it? Jetty Jet. You can do it with anything, like anyone's name. I do it with everybody's name, Cycrison or Cynicson or just double it up. Hey, not bad. If I'm not looking at the actual hangout, yeah. If I hide it, it. Huh. You are screen sharing. Am I? Yeah, let me know if you guys can see the drawing or not, because it's my computer is not lagging, and I'm wondering if that's because it's not screen sharing or is it just not lagging because it's not lagging. All right. So I am. Warm the good people up. I am warming them up. I'm warming them up. All right, let's just draw something here. So first of all, what I like to start off to do when I'm doing figures, I like to do just the basic shape. So watch this. I'm just going to do a circle for the head like this. So this. Is it laggy still? No. Well, it's been a while since I've used my desktop computer. Months since I've used my desktop computer. Feels weird. Also, I'm also using my Wacom drawing pad, which is I haven't used for the past month and a half since I got my new Cintiq from my girlfriend for my birthday. It's amazing. And I'm just, it feels so weird to be drawing the Wacom pad again. It's that disconnect, that feeling of being disconnected from your drawing pad. And because of that disconnect, you have to kind of anticipate your strokes. And as you can see, I'm not like concerned about the, like all the scribbles that I'm writing, drawing down are seeing all these scribbles. And the keys are like I said, I haven't used my desktop in probably a year now for drawing. I've been using my laptop. And I remember techniques for kind of coping with this kind of disconnect. And techniques are really, for me anyway, how I take my drawing in stages and in steps. I don't, like as you can see, I'm not worried about the clean detail. I'm just kind of gesturing all the parts of the body. And yeah, gesturing it in, even if it's scribbly, as long as it's kind of within that general direction, then it's fine. Oh shoot, you guys have been talking. This thing doesn't automatically roll for me. Oops, Jetty Jet. Dang it. I was wondering why you guys are so quiet. Let me see if I have this, if I have the conversation up right here. I'm looking through my phone to see you guys' comments. So I want to see if maybe it's better. It's going to lag if I use my desktop. Let's see. Nope. Okay. He said, whoa. No. Commercial. That's not good. Not good. Because I get copyright infringement. It's like, no, I didn't intend to play that. It came on its own. Okay. Why can't I see the chat? Okay. I can see it. What? You guys can see the drawing? You see the drawing? So you can see the drawing. Let's see here. Okay, cool. Yes, I see it. That's good. Good. And I can see it as well. So, okay. So if that's down, I'd rather look at my computer screen. Is what I'm doing is I'm setting it. Yeah, it's not lagging. Good. I can still draw and use my computer instead of my phone because it's a lot more clear to see on the, what will he draw is the question. What will I draw? I don't know what I'll draw. I don't know what I'll draw. No, no, Becky. I will not draw that. Oh, I mean Boogie Monster. We got a Boogie Monster. I'm not here. Okay. They won't be able to hear you anyway. good. I'm talking to myself. I'm talking to myself. There's no one here. There's no one here. Except me and myself. See how scribbly that is? Scribbly. Yeah, it's pretty scribbly. What if I did this? And I did this. Hey, what's up from Brazil, Lucas? Nice to have you here. Utrilus? Maybe Jet can answer it. Okay, what? Can you people recommend a cheap drawing tab for my PC? The cheapest one right now is Huion. Go with Huion. Watch Sakura's YouTube video. He does a good review on it. It's right now, I'm guessing, Wacom's competitor, and they've released what is pretty much comparable to the Wacom tablets. I haven't tried it myself, but pretty sure you can get a lot out of it, because I've used some crappy tablets back in the day, and I was able to do just fine with them. Yeah. So, Huion. So, yeah, thanks for answering the question. This is Manga Studio. And thanks, Boogie Monster, for the Cintiq. I know, I'm not using it right now. All right, John, get in on this, man. If you can hear me, get in on this. He's going to get in on this. He says. Wow. Lily Hosgood says, I've got a Huion, and I use it more than my Cintiq companion. What's up, John?
What's up? Hello. Can you give me a link to your live stream?
Yeah, it's
going. I don't.
Oh, you weren't watching this whole time? It's so funny. It seems like you're watching.
No, man.
It sounds like you're watching because you're like, keep them warmed up. I'm like, you're like, yeah.
Sorry, I'm late. The heroes always come late. You know how it is.
Oh, snap.
Just joking.
Welcome to the show, yeah. John. This is John, a good buddy of Sakura's. Actually, Sakura introduced me to John. An amazing artist. Right. He's all over the internet. You just type in his name, John. Just type in that word.
Just John. Just J. It's gonna. I'm gonna be there for sure. Okay, I see the chat. Hello, chat. How's it going? Should I share this? I'm going to share this on my...
Yeah. Hold on.
Yeah, specs. Sure. Huh? How does this work? Like the screen switches between me and you? Or?
Yeah, shit. Let me get to that real quick.
No, it's okay. I don't have anything up right now. So.
Okay, I just want to make sure it's ready for switching whenever. Let's see. Okay, say something.
Hello. 1, 2, 3. A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Okay, yeah. It switches good.
Okay. Yeah.
Lovely. Say something again one more time.
A, B, C, D.
Oh, X split. Okay. All right. I see X split. Okay. Hold on a sec. I'm not random, dude. I'm contemplative.
Okay.
Coordinated.
Okay. Like.
I got a list of things. Hold on. I got a list of things. Here, hold on. I was gonna say it when the show started, but then where did it go? I wrote it down. Oh, there it is. Okay, so Oh yeah, this one's for Sakura. You are the holy book. The holy book. Just had to get out of my system.
Wait, hold on. I'm quiet. I'm posting this stuff.
Okay. Yeah, post it up. So John.
That's me.
That's you. Just wanted to talk about what works have. Can you show us today? Because I want to show them your work.
You can just go on my DeviantArt. I guess that's
at the best. Is that the best place, or is that
that's the most updated at the moment? Because my own website, it's going under construction. So I'd say
I linked your DeviantArt. I mean your Tumblr. Okay, what's
your? I guess Tumblr as well. Yeah.
It's John's Tumblr's in the description, but let me. I'm at DeviantArt right now. Let me. What is it?
Put it this way. Tumblr has the works that I like. DeviantArt just says everything.
Okay, let me search up your name on DeviantArt. What is it? John Silva.
Yeah, just John Silva. And also, Tumblr has sketches while DeviantArt doesn't.
Okay. Guys, when I say an amazing artist, you guys don't know what I mean. I'm talking about
incredible. Is that what you make them believe?
That's what I make them believe. You guys judge. You guys decide for yourself.
Is that what you made them believe? Okay.
Oh man. Yeah. He's on a different level. Do you know what I mean? Some people's like sometimes my brain just like stops for a second because it's on a different level. It's just like, whoa. The level of detail, man, I'm serious. Level of detail and just composition and everything, it shows, and the dog Thanks, agrees. Man,
I appreciate it. Dog was like, shut up.
Yeah.
I'm almost done posting everywhere.
Oh yeah, and you also do tutorials and you give out brushes and stuff too.
I made some brushes.
Yeah, you made brushes.
I made brushes.
You are a brush.
I am the brush. Yeah. Okay, hold on. Live streaming. Jet. Live streaming. This.
Jetty jet.
Eddie.
Yeah, the jetty
live
jet.
Live streaming with.
Ooh, Alchemy Rush.
Yeah.
You got to tell them about Alchemy Rush in a second. That is okay. So you guys see all that render. You see this? See that detail? And then he does this Alchemy Rush stuff. Oh my! See? You got one of them. So John's not messing around. He's serious. And do you do this for a living?
Yes, I do.
So you live off of this?
I live off of this stuff. It's kind of weird. Ooh. It's kind of weird. It's kind of the
spot and the happy spot that we want to be in.
Right.
That. Yeah.
How do I post these?
Do you enjoy doing this?
Do
you enjoy doing this? I don't know. Maybe. Why am I doing it?
I think I'd rather be on McDonald's flipping burgers. I think.
Yeah.
I think. Yeah, I enjoy doing this, of course. I mean, otherwise, you know, with the amount of hours that I could be doing something else, I'll probably get more money earlier than art stuff. Art stuff, like the reward comes way later. Other, you know, more common jobs. If you worked as hard as you work in art, but in your regular jobs, you'd probably be promoted really fast.
That's coming from a guy who's at the top of the freaking art industry game, man.
No, I'm
not. You are at the highest like level that there is to reach in like the concept design and illustration world.
No, man.
You're over 9,000. I need two scouters.
One on each eye. Imagine. Like scouter glasses.
Double scouters.
Double scouters. I'm going to draw a character with double scouters now.
Okay, draw your... Okay.
Yeah. I'm just going to do something.
Wait, are you sharing your screen? You're not sharing. I can.
Oh, I'm not sharing. That's why nothing is appearing. Hold on. I'm like, I never use Google Hangouts, so.
We've streamed together on Google Hangout last time. You guys, if you didn't know, we were streaming last time, and he was working on a birthday present. You're just drawing.
Yeah. Screen two. Okay, can you see something? Can you see anything?
I can see something.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
There you are.
Sup? Okay, it's working?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good.
Good.
Now, let me open the chat. This should have been all done before.
No, it's cool. Live. I got the chat. I got the chat. You can take over the show. You can take over the show. I'll look at the chat.
But I like reading people.
Yeah, he does. You guys, he actually does his live streams too on live stream.
On live stream.
On live stream, the original live stream. And that's in the description too. And
oh, RJ Palmer is here. I work with that guy. He did cool stuff.
Who?
RJ Palmer, the guy who does Pokemon stuff.
RJ Palmer!
Yeah.
I think I met you, Jet. Probably don't remember, but we met at art school briefly. Huh. I think I know RJ. That's what I'm saying. I know RJ.
Live streams as well.
RJ, we miss you.
He does, yeah.
Yeah.
So, I live stream. I don't know. I've been trying to live stream regularly. I'm just going to draw what I drew yesterday, but better. It's a warm up. Many, many drawings are going to come, but.
So, tell us about what is that? Your personal project.
Oh, Alchemy Rush? I can't really talk.
I can. Basically your personal project.
So Alchemy Rush is a comic that I'm working on. Not like a universe. And it's cool. It's cool to draw that. I can't tell much about like the story.
Don't tell too much. Just draw. Just draw. It's good.
But it's inspired by many
influences.
I got many influences.
Yeah, I was gonna ask you that too. What is your influence in art? Like, what?
So basically, I got these two things, right? I got the comic style and I got the realistic stuff, the crazy renderings and whatever, whatnot. But
the crazy renderings. Yeah, you look at the drawing that you're doing right now and just like. Most people would say if you just stopped right there and then said the same person did the other stuff, it's just like
it's two completely different things. Yeah, I mean my comic stuff is more simple, more like fun and easygoing, and my illustration work, it's more serious stuff, but. Did you show them some of my?
Yeah, I just went. I was flipping through your drawings. So,
on Tumblr, I think I have the Alchemy Rush.
Yeah.
Character explorations. That's me. Like on live stream, I do that kind of stuff. I just doodle characters that look like they fit in the.
Yeah, that's the best part about your personal project. You just doodle and dabble whatever you want to. Dude, it's your own story.
Exactly.
Bring them out to life. It's awesome.
And
just exploration.
Yeah, right now I'm just sketching and searching for stuff, but actually I don't want to draw this. I'm going to draw something else. I just had an idea. And this is how it goes. I mean,
this is how it goes.
Start something and then I change it and then I. Okay.
Okay.
Let's. But anyway, for the live stream today, I guess I can just show my process. Yeah.
Yeah, I know what you said. Like, you see how he's kind of stopping? It's difficult talking and drawing at the same time. Some people have gotten really good at it, like Zagra and Bob. I think they've been doing
pretty good at it too. But
who?
I've been it for. Me.
Oh yeah, you've done it, but then it takes a while. It's like
For I mean, it's just because I didn't warm up. I haven't drawn today, so because it's weekend. That's mainly it. I'm thinking of like something cool to actually draw instead of talking. But yeah, anyway, look at me rush process. I mean, I can't wait to actually put out some pages because I am going to, you know, I'm not just going to sell it or something. Mm-hmm. First going to see what the internet, see how you guys react to it. If you like it, if you don't like it. And I want to make this a different color.
They said that because I asked what is your influence, and people are screaming out Dragon Ball Z. It's so funny. It's so funny. Did you tell them?
I haven't told anybody, but it's like, obvious.
No, I don't understand how it's obvious. It's
I don't know. Like, okay, so
you barely made a few strokes. It could be anything.
Right. So it's like this. Yeah. Obviously it's like my main love is basically Dragon Ball. Like many, many, many people. And the funny thing is, like I was saying yesterday when we were talking, the funny thing is I always been drawing illustration work. I wasn't on the side before, you know, drawing comic stuff. But one day when I decided, okay, I've been having this idea for some time now. Slowly I'm getting more and more free time, thankfully. Yeah. And I want to do a comic. I want to do something cool, something for myself, you know. It doesn't have to sell, doesn't have to be huge. It's just for myself. If it goes well, it goes well. If no, then I'll still do it for myself, post it online for anybody who's interested. And this guy's missing a finger. And yeah, so that's the bit, like how I started, how I got started. But the funny thing, talking about Dragon Ball, mm-hmm. is that the first drawing, and this is like, I was not drawing Dragon Ball, I wasn't doing anything, but like automatically, like the first character that I was doing, I'm like, oh shit. can I swear here? Is there? Yeah. Okay. I was like, yeah, oh shit, this really looks like I have really a lot of influences inside of, you know, my brain. It's just automatically what I'm gonna fish for when drawing stuff. But I have many other influences, obviously, like Full Metal Alchemist. Actually, I got the name, obviously, Alchemy Rush from Full Metal Alchemist, but it's different. The story is not the same, and it's not about the same thing where there's transmutation or anything. One thing I can tell you about Alchemy Rush is that the alchemy in this world,
yeah,
it's as if it were key. It's like as if it was key in, I don't know, any other manga that uses key, really. You know, Dragon Ball, obviously, but it's like a power, right?
Yeah.
And I want this to be a very like lively adventure kind of. I don't like this hand. Draw it. Yeah, I while the drawings can be cool, I really want to focus on the story. Writing is another thing that I'm not used to. I love making up stuff, but organizing it and putting it on the paper is like, it's a whole different.
So have you written any of that stuff?
Yeah, I have more like bullet points, you know, and then organizing everything.
Yeah.
Because I wanted to make it a universe, so I could write, I don't know, 50 stories, but still same universe, you know.
Yeah.
And what else? What else can I say? Interesting, like making interesting characters, not your typical superhero kind of stuff. I want it to be a little crazy. I also love One Piece, and I love parts of the craziness of One Piece.
Yeah.
You know, that make it really
I was thinking about One Piece. And yeah, One Piece is so... Damn it, I'm getting feedback. It's so original. You know? It's like... Hello? Hello?
Yeah, I'm listening.
Keep going. No. Because I'm plugging into two sounds. What I'm saying is... One Piece, I was thinking about it the other day, and I was saying, how can you diversify your character, like your cast of characters?
Mm.
Because you want to make every single character memorable. You don't want them all to be like just every single character is just beautiful and pretty characters. No one's going to stand apart.
Exactly. That's one thing also with Dragon Ball.
Yeah.
Since we're on that topic. Like with Dragon Ball, if you really notice, the villains, the way they're drawn are not too much different. Like they all have the same kind of design to them. It's just that it's a little bit shuffled down and the design is switched. And the number one thing that makes the difference is the colors. And a lot of the DBZ heroes as well, it's like same face for like five characters. And I don't know how I want this freaking hand. Okay, I know what I'm going to do.
What's wrong with the hand? It's fine. A lot of people saying they like Fullmetal Alchemist is a good anime manga. Mango? It's a mango.
It's like this Fullmetal Alchemist. Well, the art style is amazing. I really love the art style. But the story development of the manga and of the new... The old anime, not so much, but the newer one, I actually preferred the story development of that. It's something that you don't see much. Like, tell me any other anime that's like that and as good as that, obviously, you know?
Yeah.
But
I actually haven't seen Fullmetal Alchemist.
You have to. It's.
I have to.
You have to.
Man, I have to. When did you watch it, though? Because maybe... Is it going to hold up even as an older guy?
Oh, yeah. I actually rewatched it as, as an adult now. And yeah. I enjoyed it even more. Because I understood, you know, it goes a little bit deep. So I'm redoing the head again. Because, you know what? Screw the hand for now. I'm going to draw the rest of the body.
You had such an awesome hand like so many times and you just keep changing it.
That's how it is. That's another thing with drawing comics or, you know, even just character exploration.
Yeah.
As opposed to illustration, you redraw really a lot. In illustration, kind of like do thumbnails, then you pick one or your art director picks one, and then you go on from that and then refine, right? There's not much... changes. Well, in comics, since every scene is different, you just gotta redraw, especially the same character so many times. That's another thing that I actually found myself liking really a lot is redrawing the same character, like over and over again.
Yeah, and it'll evolve. What do you think about like the evolution of your character? Oh. Do you want it to evolve, or do you want to keep it kind of like stuck to the original design?
It's always evolving, especially at the early stage of development. You know, even after the comic goes out, you know, you anyway, as you keep drawing, it will change. Like, look at any other long-term comic, anime. You know, manga.
Or any comic book, right?
Yeah.
So has Jetty ever read Feng Shenji? Ask the audience, because the audience will know this question. I've never read it. Have you?
Met him?
Have Met you that person? Read Feng Shengji.
Not is that sounds Chinese, and I probably didn't. How do you write that? Let me search really quick.
Feng. Watch this. I'll write it. Feng.
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 Feng Shui? No, that's a movie. No.
Feng Shengji.
What? How's the second one? G is easy.
No.
Feng Shengji?
Or Cavalier of the Abyss. Hold on, one name at a time. Feng Sheng.
Cavalier of the Abyss. Okay, I got that one. Let me see. Let me look at it. No. Cavalier of the Beasts. I haven't. Looks cool though, some parts. Like the drawings are cool. I'm really into, and this is another subconsciously my another manga I really look up to is One Man Punch. One Hero Punch. Wait.
Oh, is that the boxing one?
One Punch Man. No. Wait.
One Punch Man.
One Punch Man. Yeah, the One Punch Man. It's getting an anime, actually. I've been reading that. It's so hilarious, but it can get serious really, really quick as well. And that's one thing that Dragon Ball was really good at. And this manga definitely draws inspiration from that as well.
Mm-hmm.
It's just so... fresh. I don't know how to say that. It's really my type of manga.
Yeah.
You know, or even comics. I'm not really into hero comics as much as I like, for example, X-Men and
yeah,
things like that. But I was never really into American comics. Maybe because where I grew up, actually, anime seemed to be more popular.
Where are you from?
I'm from Portugal.
Oh.
But like Dragon Ball Fever came out really fast. Like it was spread like fire in the woods. It was
spreading fire in the woods.
Yeah.
Stop this cartoon. It's making fires in the Portuguese woods.
It was really this hand, goddamn it. I'm gonna keep redrawing this hand until I finally, you know what? I can't draw a hand, so he's gonna be Mega Man now. It's okay.
It's just gonna be Mega Man.
All right, don't worry about it. I got it. It's gonna be Mega Man. Yeah. So I guess because Dragon Ball became so damn popular, like really quick, then you know other comics and other animes, they become really popular, especially because of that we had the channel specifically to anime, so all the Sailor Moon and Tsubasa, all the old animes like Oh My Goddess and all that stuff. I watched all of that.
You guys are so lucky. You guys got all those cartoons. We didn't get any of those unless you had.
Yeah, we were lucky. We were lucky. And if there's any Portuguese here, it's the channel Panda. The channel was called Panda. That's how Asian they went.
Panda.
Panda.
That's racist!
Right?
No. They're supporting us, man. I'm American anyway. Who am I talking?
Yeah. You got no place.
Yeah, I got no place in this.
So, got a cute boy, Mega Man hand. I can draw the other hand, all right? I'll draw the other hand. But,
Yeah,
so I have, like, all my, the way I draw, at least, I really draw inspiration from old mangas and old animes. That's the kind of feel I want my manga to have. I'm not really into the new stuff, honestly, aside from One Punch Man, because it's relatively new, but the guy is an old school guy. You can tell that. And I really, really like his sense of humor and everything.
One Punch Man. I have to check that out. I've never heard of it.
You have, like, sure. If you guys haven't, really, it's really good from beginning to till the end. It's like, oh well, there's no end because it didn't finish.
It's so crazy. That's one of the things I wonder. Is like, you okay? How long, first of all, how long does it take to finish one of your really detailed drawings on average? Like,
okay, so my off from the comic stuff. So my realistic stuff, it takes me about, you know, working on and off takes me about a week. I work really hard, like we're talking about anywhere between 8 to 10 hours every single day. then it takes me 3.5 days for like the really serious stuff, because each client is different, you know.
Yeah.
Those who pay more, and you know, they pay more, then I gotta spend more time as well, etc.
Sometimes it would even take like 2 weeks, did you say?
If there's more characters, like for example, I have an upcoming illustration to do that has like 5 characters in it, and it's a really high paid job, and that one I will have to spend, I don't know, 2 weeks, because there's so much going on, and each single character, I can't, you know how sometimes you draw illustrations and you kind of can hide stuff behind stuff? You know, like you can hide the character behind another one, maybe you can just draw the torso or something like this. Like, no. This one, I really gotta, I think I'm gonna make this character have a pet robot.
No, because I asked that because it seems like you're always working, and you were showing me all your work the other day, and it was just like, it just didn't stop. You're working on like 10 multiple drawings, and that's not an exaggeration. I think it was like really, really detailed, crazy drawings. At the same time, you read and reread mangas.
Not all the time. It sounds like, yeah, but what I usually do is like I'll crack up some work, just finish whatever I have to finish, and I'll have, you know, spare time. Then I'll just, I read really fast, probably because that's all I've been doing is reading comics. I don't read normal books as much as I'd like to. It's just easier for me to, I'm a picture kind of guy, you know what I mean? But make like some cool eyes on these robots.
This is, I should watch Hunter x Hunter.
Hunter x Hunter, I heard it's really good. I've seen some stuff. It seems really fun.
Yeah. I watched like the first episodes. It's one of those cartoons. I was like, man, I gotta keep going. I'm just lazy.
Yeah,
it's really good. It's really good. I liked it.
I heard that it's one of those cartoons. Like, it gets better and better and better. Like, you kind of have to develop, you know, like the. Each episode, you just gotta keep on going.
Sadness, sadness, cry, cry, hiatus, epic, epic. HXH has many names. I guess they have different names for that cartoon. There are 20 years worth of anime, and at least 10 years of it are forgotten, and probably only 5% are really good.
Yeah. You know what's a really, cool anime / erotic kind of anime, but it's not really. But the style, the art style of Golden Boy. I don't know if you guys remember. It's so good.
That's the harem, is it? Not harem.
The harem, yeah.
It's not quite harem, but it's definitely one of those genres that defeats the rest.
I think you don't really see the girls naked aside from one scene or two, but it's always like all suggested stuff, like sexually suggested stuff. But it's really good. It's so funny.
There's a funny,
so funny,
funniest scene I love so much. He like was walking with that girl and he's holding her hand, and then he's like. No. The girl's holding his hand and she's like guiding him. he's imagining his hand turned into his
penis.
literally drew it. It was hilarious.
Yeah. There's this scene I'll never forget. Yeah. There's this scene where what's his name? Keiichiro? No. It's K something. Anyway, it doesn't matter. The main character of this anime, he meets this biker girl, right? He's on his bike. Like, this is the funniest thing. He's always on his bike, traveling from place to place because he doesn't have a home. He's always traveling around Japan. And he's really good at drawing as well. But anyway, that's just a side note. So anyway, he's going on his bike. He hears some moaning at night. What is this? He goes and check it, and there's a girl on the motorbike, you know, like, you know, huge cleavage showing up and stuff, and she's like making the vibrations of the car to, you know, pleasure herself. And he gets caught on, and she's like, "Oh, you like what you see and stuff."
The motorcycle.
If you want this, yeah, the summarized version is, if you want this, we gotta race. But they have to race. But he doesn't have a motorbike. He has just a bicycle. You know. And he's riding on his bike, and he has to pedal really fast, right? And of course, you know, they start the race, and she basically disappears on the horizon. And he starts pedaling really, really fast. And then there's this, like, the road gets really steep, and it goes down really a lot. And he doesn't have brakes. Like, his brakes break. Right, so he can't stop himself, but while he's pedaling, I can't remember exactly what he's saying, but I think it's in Japanese, mate, right? Yeah. But he's like, mate, and he keeps getting faster and faster, he keeps repeating that, it's all the time, mate. It's so goddamn funny with his expression and everything. And then eventually he passes her, right? Yeah. And he wins. And in this anime, it's like this, that the guy always, the main hero, he never gets laid. But at the end of each episode, he does something incredible that the girls want him. You know, for example, in this case, he won the race. And she was like, oh, you beat my, I don't know.
Bimbo baby.
My Suzuki or whatever motorbike she had. Like, hey, you beat her. I want you. But the problem is that he cannot brake. So he goes off a cliff. And then he freaking disappears and never finds her because he just keeps on pedaling forever.
Yeah.
It's really funny. Every single episode is like that. He does something amazing. The girls go crazy for him, but something happens that
he's just gone.
And the funny thing is that throughout the whole episode, he's after them. So there's that contrast. Anyway. It's really funny. Like, you know, it's not really hentai at all. It's more like funny adult stuff. But anyway.
You guys gotta check that one out if you guys haven't seen it yet. Check it out. You guys! Even girls. I think girls enjoy
it. I watched it with my fiancé.
Yeah, I watched it.
It was really funny. It's really funny.
Becky, she still remembers, it's funny, she just said Bimbo Baby. It's the bike's name.
Oh, it's the bike? Yeah, okay.
Bimbo Baby. I don't even remember that. So
I watched it so long time ago, but it's so goddamn funny. Anyway.
What are they saying here?
My point is, that kind of, the art style, that's 80s/90s. Art style, whether it's anime or manga, I really like that. It's probably, you know, I'm just... I grew up during that time, that's probably why, but...
Yeah, same for me. I totally was influenced by the 90s animes, and it all shows through my drawings all the time.
Yeah, like, it's exactly the same with me.
Yeah.
And... I don't know, I actually been analyzing. I like new animes, don't get me wrong. Just not many... I like new animes that have a good drawing foundation, especially since we're artists. I get really picky about what anime I watch. Because if it doesn't look good, or some stuff is just like, oh my god, then I can't watch it. I just get caught up on the drawing, and I'm like, no, I can't watch this. With that said, one of the more cartoony animes that I really, really liked, and it's relatively new, is Soul Eater, if you know that. Do you know that?
I know the name, and yeah, I've not seen it yet.
Have to watch it. It's really, really cool.
Shoot. Soul Eater and Full Metal Alchemist. All right.
I'd actually put Full Metal Alchemist as the first priority, but Soul Eater is amazing. It's really, 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 really good. But yeah, those are some of my favorites, so you guys can get an idea for the kind of stuff I'm inspired to. Now, my illustration work It's a little different, of course, because everything has to be real, etc., or more on the real side, and the comic side, obviously. And that I have few like old masters that I like. I like Bogoro. He's really good.
Bogoro.
Yeah.
Bogoro?
Yeah. I think that's how you say it. French guy. Oh. He's that.
Oh.
I like, of course, Frank Frazetta, but I don't really follow his stuff. I just really like the way he draws. A huge, when it comes for realistic stuff, a huge inspiration for me is Ian McCaig.
Oh, man. Drawing.
He's amazing.
God.
Yeah. He's a drawing guy. Well, he can paint as well, but
my
main inspiration is drawing. Also, when I paint, I actually spend more time on the drawing phase than on the painting phase, because what I came to find out, well, first of all, I love drawing. If I had to choose, oh, you only draw or paint for the rest of your life, then I'd rather choose drawing. But his stuff is like this that, you know, it's just so amazing. And he can draw in a way that looks painted as well. And that's one thing that I realized when I was actually doing the opposite, painting more and just kind of like just drawing, you know, painting the shapes and then drawing loosely on top. Mm-hmm. My illustrations were feeling like they're a little bit weaker than they actually should be.
What?
And what?
Oh, shoot, I freaking forgot.
You're gonna ask something.
No, continue.
I can see? Okay. So, looking at Ian McCaig's stuff, I'm like, this is amazing. Like, he can draw in a way that you can easily paint. Like, I'd pick up his drawings, and I would paint on top so that whatever theory I was thinking in my head would actually make sense. And it does. Like, the way he draws is so accurate that when you actually do an underpainting and an overpainting, it's so easy to tell the forms, you know? And it's like a map. You know where everything goes before you actually paint. And I just like that. Some people don't. I mean, a lot of people don't. They prefer to do the blob kind of style painting where you just paint the blob and then you work on that, almost like sculpting, you know?
Sculpting and silhouettes and stuff.
Yeah. That's the fastest way, and this is what I was gonna get on to, is that drawing is not the fastest way of actually, you know, oh, I got a deadline. I'm going to draw a very detailed drawing, and I'm going to paint on top. Like, no. While your painting might have been better if you do that, it's definitely not the fastest, and I have to keep on going back and forth, you know, do blob painting, and then whenever I do have time, I go back to just, you know, drawing instead of
instead
of doing the blob painting style.
Blob painting styles, it's so efficient and fast when you need it.
Yeah, when it's like deadline tomorrow, you just got to do that, right? But you miss on a lot of stuff, and your stuff might be a little less accurate if you're used to and you can pre-visualize stuff before you actually paint them on. I can't do that. I tried, and I have to see the drawing underneath so that I can...
not Kim Jong-gi style.
But King Jim, what? I don't want to say King Jim-il. Wait, what? He's an awesome painter as well, I heard.
Yeah. But he paints, what I mean is, like, he kind of pre-visualizes it and just...
No, I can preview, I mean...
Kind of like what you're doing right now.
It's what I'm doing right now, right? I'm not doing any under sketching and then over, right? This is what I still consider a sketch, just because the lines are rough. But I didn't do any building up before I actually arrived to this situation. Yeah, direct. With painting is a little different, because with the pen, you have to think about is shapes and perspective. Of course, design, etc., but you don't have to think about values, you don't have to think about colors, you don't have to think, well, just those two are preloaded, you know?
Yeah.
And when you do blob painting, you have to do two or even three at the same time, you know? If you're painting directly with color and you have to select the correct value with the color, then you have to think three steps ahead. You know what I'm saying?
So if you guys don't know John, I'm about to blow you guys' brains away right now with this. This is what I just remembered what I was going to ask you. What art school did you go to?
What art school? I haven't gone to any art school.
Oh, you didn't go to art school? What?
No.
What?
There's many people out there.
But how can you draw so well? How do you have so much information? What the heck? Did you learn everything?
When I started, actually, okay, so I know what you're trying to do. Show people that you don't have to go to art school. You don't.
I'm blowing their brains away. I told you.
You don't have to go to art school at all. Even to get jobs, you can be having like three art schools done, and if you're not good enough, you're not gonna get work. Yeah. It's just how it is. I mean, that's the reality of things, yeah. And it becomes even more and more and more like that. What am I doing with these clouds?
Your jobs are like 10 times bigger than mine's, and do they ask you for your degree?
No, never. Even to get work, the only thing that I saw myself having a trouble with that required some sort of degree was getting a visa. And that's it. Aside from that, no one is going to, you know, it might say, for example, oh, you want to apply to Blizzard. And at the end of the requirements before you apply to them, it says, oh, optional degree or a plus if you have a degree on this and that, whatever your position you're applying for. But that's just for, you want me to tell you the real thing? That's really just for a legal kind of, it makes them look more professional, and it's more on the legal side of things, yeah. You know? So yeah. It's more like, oh, we have these, but you don't, you absolutely don't have to have. In fact, I don't even have high school, and I just want to say that I dropped out of my high school like 3 months before I graduated, and what? I don't advise anybody to do that. Because if shit goes down, you do need at least a high school diploma for your regular jobs. So I just want to say that, you know, I was lucky, and I don't really advise anybody. Like, unfortunately, life was like this on me, that happened. I don't want to get into details on why I dropped out. But, if you're in high school, finish it, like 100%. If I had the opportunity and I had to, and there was no other choice aside from dropping out, then I kind of want to make this gun have a smoke coming out. Anyway, if you're in high school, just do it. Although the reality is, high school is not even required unless you're moving into a country that requires you a visa, because then it comes like legal stuff. Like, with the visa, it has nothing to do with work, but you need minimum what you call it, education done, right?
I think your fans are here. I got like a lot of... I got 92 viewers watching right now. It's just a lot. Thanks, everybody, for joining. If you guys are just tuning in, this is John Silva.
Hi.
Special guest today. We're just doing a Saturday morning drawing cartoon, and we're streaming live. I'm probably going on for probably another hour, and that's probably it. We're not going to do too much.
I don't know. We'll see how it goes.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll just take this, or, you know, organically.
Yeah.
organically. We can do it until like for 2 days, you know, until somebody passes out, until everybody passes out.
That's until zero viewers. Right, but anyway, education. How do you like? Do you need it in terms of college? Do you need college? No, like not at all. No art education whatsoever. You don't need to. But with that said, you know, don't go now and just cancel your school, education. Your education, right?
Yeah.
It's like this. There's a trade-off. You have to be really, really disciplined because there's nobody next to you holding your hand and telling you that, you know, go this way, go that way, do this, do that. However, sometimes it would be better off depending on what school you are, because a lot of schools don't teach properly. So a lot of times what's going to happen is you come out of school or you come out of college or art school or whatever, and you have to redo a lot of the things. You have to actually unlearn even. I have friends, they had to unlearn stuff because it was not proper.
You talking about art-related or just...
I'm talking about art. Okay, yeah, I'm talking about teachers, you know, art school teachers.
Yeah. Agreed.
If you're a kind of person that you know you can do things by yourself, you definitely can. Especially nowadays, there's so much information online, and you were asking me, Jet, how did I got all the information and stuff. I got it a lot from books and talking to other professionals. At that time, actually, I was also really lucky because it started a boom of illustrators starting to live stream. So there was really like top-notch illustrators live streaming, and you could ask them questions, right?
Yeah.
So
you were following the live streams when you were still learning, and you were that.
When I was still learning. I already knew live stream because that's how I got a lot of my information, actually, because there were so many really, really good professionals working, and they already had it kind of figured it out.
Yeah.
And actually, I started live streaming pretty early as well, even though I wasn't professional, like, at all. I wasn't professional at all, and
so I was basically there's a bunch of John. There can be some John Silvas inside the audience right now.
Oh, definitely, there's better than John Silva's in the audience. It's all about how hard you work. For myself, like the information I got a lot from books, and I was lucky enough to start painting at a time, which was, I started painting 4 years ago. So when you think about it, it's not a long time at all. It's actually pretty short when all things considered.
It's really short.
And
I didn't even know that. Everything else, I was just playing dumb. But that one, I didn't know. 4 years ago?
Yeah, I only started painting 4 years ago. And anything before that, I was drawing very occasionally. I actually liked playing guitar more. Like, I liked doing music more at that time than drawing. Although, I did like drawing. Don't get me wrong. But it's something that I was never thinking I could do as a job. I thought I was going to be a musician, you know?
Yeah.
That's
why you got. That's why you dropped out of school, because you were like, "I'm a musician."
No, I wish it was. I wish it was that, but it was a little bit more dramatic.
Wish it was okay. Good, good. I'm sorry to hear that. I won't ask.
It's okay. Yeah. It's a little sad, but anyway, I don't want people to.
Don't worry about it.
So yeah, what was I saying?
Saying school.
Yeah. Okay, so
I
started doing art at a time where it was already...
You were talking about your painting, you just started, yeah.
Yeah, I just started, and most of my information, aside from live streams, I was also getting it from the internet. Literally Googling, like Google was like my teacher for the most part. I did all kinds of searches, to be honest. Like, I remember one search that really helped me was Atelier Techniques.
Mm-hmm.
And that really got me going. There was one website. I remember the color. I don't remember the name. The color of the website was kind of like a brownish, like a magenta kind of, not magenta, like this color. I can give you the color here on the screen.
That's like a beige, a mustard. That's
like a mustard. Yeah, like a mustard beige. Yeah.
Actually, my phone's tinted red, so maybe it's a little more green. I don't know.
No. Actually, that's pretty.
It's pretty red. Okay.
Yeah. So and this website had so much information about their atelier, and you know what kind of works students were doing. You know, they had to give some kind of example so that people would apply to their school. But I used that information to do it for myself. They had a schedule and everything. What kind of, like, the keywords, especially since English is not my main language. Mm-hmm. It was really hard in the beginning because I was pretty fluent already in English because I was living in Ireland for a few years. That's where I dropped out of school.
Well, you were talking with like top of the morning to you, to people.
No. I was the only one who didn't have an accent.
It's one of my favorite accents, by the way.
British, not British, like, well, British-ish
English.
Accent. Yeah. So I was more into the American way of talking, because I used to game a lot, and I talked to a lot of gamers on the microphone, and most of them were Americans. You know, I used to play a lot of MMOs, and there was this MMO I used to play a lot called Ragnarok Online.
I think people will know Ragnarok.
Yeah.
So big.
It was so big, yeah. But anyway,
yeah.
I'm derailing right now.
Derail. We all derail. This is the Jetty Jet Show, man. It's all about derailing.
So, so the atelier, going back.
Yeah.
So if you find any website and they, not necessarily it says blatantly, oh, here's how you do things. Like, you got to do your own searches. And I think that's something that I gain, that I really appreciate, because nowadays it's very easy to reach out a professional, and that's actually quite good. I'm not saying it's a bad thing, but there is a little trap to it, is that you become, what's the word? Like,
idealistic.
No.
What are you talking about?
You feel like every time you have a problem, you become very dependable. Dependable? Is that the word? You depend on people? What's the word?
Yeah.
Anyway, like, you depend too much on
dependent.
Professionals. Dependent. A dependent person. Okay, so there you go. You become like a dependent person, dependent on professionals. So you'll ask one professional, it will help you. Then you ask another one, he might have a different opinion. And you kind of, at one point, you ask so many professionals that you become a little confused. Because some are going to say, oh, no, this is the right way. Oh, no. This is the way.
Oh, my goodness.
And again, take anything that you hear from me, take it with a grain of salt. All my opinions and everything is just coming from experience. And most professional artists, they will actually say that, you know, they'll warn, like, this is just my experience, for you it might be different, blah blah blah, like a little pre-warning before giving out any information. But some don't. Some are just like, no, do like this is the way.
I've had some top professionals tell me personally, like, "Oh, you'll never get anywhere. You'll only be doing this kind of art. With that kind of art, you're gonna be stuck doing this and this." I'm like, why? First of all, why are you kind of criticizing that art? They were saying, like, "Oh, comic art. You're just gonna be stuck with comic art if you're gonna do like that." I'm like, okay,
right?
It's just, and it was a teacher. Yeah. I'm talking about, like.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. Okay. I remember you told me about this.
Yeah. Anyways,
but
that's the kind of thinking that just steer away from. Don't get caught up in that this is the way kind of thinking.
Yeah. So what I'm trying to get at is you want to ask people, but you want to formulate your own answers. And this is huge. Like, don't take this for granted. And I know that's probably 80% of you will forget it by tomorrow, which is okay.
Yeah, not everybody's going to be.
Not everybody, but most people. Yeah. And I've done this long enough to know, you know, who's actually serious about this stuff and who's not.
Yeah.
But if you're really serious about this, make an effort to get information by yourself. And by yourself, I mean, you know, Google things. When you put hard work into something, you take it less for granted. It's like a psychological thing.
Yeah.
And if you take it less for granted, you're going to remind it more often. If you're going to remind it more often, means that you're going to do it more often. If you're going to do it more often, you're just a badass because you freaking, you know, you're up there. You're working hard. You're going to get good really, really fast because you remember things. And art is all about remembering. You know, how can you pull shit out of your head? You remember. I mean, honestly, that's really it. You just tap down into your memory and your visual library, and that's how you make shit happen. That's how you make designs, like mixing designs and things like that. You draw inspirations from your brain. Now, when you look at something directly, it's kind of like a segue into learning things by yourself. When you do studies, which I've done a lot, the exact same thing applies where when you do a study, you want to formulate your own theory. You read things about books. Try them. When you read the book, don't just read the book. Try the theory that this person is writing about. I know it's a book. I know this person is very important or like everybody got Loomis, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Even if, depending on their whatever statuses they have, try it out. Make it that it's 100% sure. Don't take an information and say, oh, this person said it, you know? So it must be true. No. It might be true for this person, and it might make sense for this person. Doesn't mean it's going to be for you.
Mm-hmm.
And the same is with anything that I'm saying here. You know, you can disregard whatever I'm saying as well. But instead of 100% disregarding off the bat, try it. Whatever I suggested here, try it. If I'm wrong, then I'm wrong. You know?
Yeah.
But
put it to application. It's all about
Exactly. Study something, you apply it. You read something, you apply it and see if that's really how it is. You know, if you mix blue and green, are you going to get red, even though it's written in the book? No. You're not going to get red.
Says, Jet, he just jealous of the good one. This fella, the good one.
Good one. No, I just know how it is because I have so many people asking me for this stuff that I don't like giving advice like, do it my way. No. Do it your way. I can only give you like a little suggestion how you can go about doing it your way. But I'm talking for experience. I was super, like I would see an artist that I love and I would try to become that artist. You know?
That was
wrong because I would never be as good as this artist because this artist is as good as he is because he's himself, you know? And the moment I stopped looking at artists in a way like, oh, I'm going to copy everything. Like, I'm going to even sleep the same way you do. I'm going to eat the same stuff. Like, you know?
Oh.
Like, any of that kind of mentality when it comes to art, it's dangerous. Because it will work. It's weird because you'll do the thing, and you're like, oh, my God, this actually looks really good. But you're going to hit a wall. Why? Because this artist developed whatever way he's drawing, whatever artist you're looking at. He developed his own theories, you know? He's not looking at every single artist and be like, oh, I have the eyes of this artist, and I have the rendering of that. While that's good, because the more you mix, the less you actually the less you actually focus on one specific artist, then you can become more unique.
Yeah.
It still can become a trap. Doesn't have to exactly, but I had to. My personal experience is that I had to stop looking at artists in a way that I want to become like that. Now you can become inspired by them and like, oh, he does this one really cool thing. Like for example, when I'm doing my comic, I'm like, yeah, Akira Toriyama. No matter how I try hard to, it's just ingrained in my body too much. Probably because of my childhood. But still, I do try to... I don't look at his stuff. I mean, I watched Dragon Ball, and I'm rewatching it now because my fiancé never watched it. And we're finishing Dragon Ball.
Yeah.
We're at the Buu saga.
Really?
So, yeah. And also, it's a good preparation for the new Dragon Ball that's coming out. Yeah. If you guys don't know, new Dragon Ball is coming out called Dragon Ball Super. So it's a good kind of like segue into that. But
I introduced Becky to Dragon Ball Z too, and we got to, I think, Frieza, and we kind of just stopped there because we're like, let's take a break, but we never picked it back up.
With us, there's no taking breaks. We either start and we finish it. It's also easier for us. We live together, and you guys don't.
Yeah.
So... you know, we're all the time together. I take a break and stuff. Oh, you want to watch DBZ then? Yeah. But we do take, like, we haven't watched Dragon Ball in almost a week, I want to say. Maybe a little less. Anyway, derail. I don't want to bore you guys too much. So I'm going to finish by saying, be inspired by others, but formulate your own ideas and theories, and the only way to formulate it is by testing. Be a little bit of a scientist. You don't know how to mix colors? You don't have to read a book. I mean, just go mix colors. See what each color, you know, if the guy who didn't have the color chart and then made the color chart, yeah, doesn't matter.
Chart, you got it.
Chart. The guy who made the color chart didn't have the color chart. How did he make it? You know? He had to probably mix all the freaking colors as many as he could and spent a long time doing it.
Yeah.
Do you think he was, after doing that, he wasn't like super knowledgeable about color and stuff? Like you can only read as many tips, you know, you can only read as many, and I'm not hating on anything. I love the magazine Imagine Effects, but those kind of tutorials, they will help you on a very short term to give you ideas on how to do certain things, but they are not solutions.
They're so specific too, you know, like kind of like how to draw elephants. I'm like, okay, I'm not really interested in elephants. Do I just start learning elephants right now?
It's more like how this artist draws elephants, you know? That's how you gotta look at things.
Yeah.
But anyway, I rant too much.
Exactly. No, ranting is good, dude. It's good. Otherwise, I'd be sitting here in the quiet.
I really, like, I'm really passionate when it comes to giving information like this because I was, and, you know, there still remains in me of, you know, other artists, and I was a person who was just very, God damn it, there's a specific word that could, anyway.
I have the same problem, man, and I'm American born, so.
You're America.
America.
Maybe I need to eat more meat.
Really?
More bear meat. Isn't that how you guys get your accent from? More bear meat.
Yeah.
No, I'm joking.
I've had a couple bears in my life. No, I haven't.
Did you ever actually eat bear meat? Is that a thing?
No.
That's not a thing. That's illegal, right?
That's illegal. You can't eat a bear. You can't eat bear. You can't eat... What is he?
Anyway.
Yeah.
I'm still sketching these doing infinite clouds because I was focusing on talking, so I didn't actually have to draw anything.
Yeah, but he's so Miyazaki-esque to me.
Oh, Miyazaki, that's another one. That's another one that's get really influenced. That is the word I was searching for.
Yeah, that's the one.
I used to be a super over-the-top influenced type of artist.
That's what they're saying. Practice and science of drawing. You know, me and Psychra used to say this all the time. We talked about science and scientists back in the day. They were all artists. Like, whatever they were studying, they were so good draftsmen.
That's true. That's
engineers. Right. You study bugs, man, you had to draw every single bug because they didn't have cameras.
Exactly.
You study plants, you have to draw every single plant from every cell and every stem and stalk. It's just, and they became really good at it. And I think that's what it really is, because I find that I relate with scientists. Like, when I was a kid, I wanted to be a scientist. That's it. I was like, I'm going to be a scientist. And instead, I became an artist. So, in a way.
I definitely. Yeah, we're kind of scientists when you really think. Like, I sometimes feel too much of a. Not a scientist, but there's a different word. Yeah, like, I learned so much about, like, light, how light actually works. Like, the more information about the specific subject and the deeper you go, the more understanding you have of it. And with the more understanding, the better you're at bending the rules. And that's what really studies are for when you actually do studies and you're thinking while you're doing studies instead of copying the image mindlessly. So you're thinking about the image and you're studying it, and then you can, the more you memorize it, that thing over and over again, you can actually start exploring and bending what you learn, you know? Just do it differently but still accurately. Or accurately looking. Mm-hmm. One of the best people that I read about, and again going back to Ian McCaig, he has this not tutorial. He has this interview. His interviews feel like tutorials as well. Like, he always explains all the time, and I love that. I do that a lot too, even when people don't ask. Just in my nature, but it's like he explains things so well. And when he was explaining one of his interviews, he was explaining when he stopped actually doing what other artists do and basically doing what I'm trying to tell you guys to do, to be yourself and stop looking at other artists in a way of copying them. You can be inspired by them. You might remember one thing or two, whatever, but don't have that artist photo opened and paint while you're looking at that artist, because it's going to look like that, unless there's one little specific thing that you think it's really cool, but it doesn't influence your whole painting, you know? So Ian McCaig, when he was a young artist, I want to say he was already working anyway, but he used to love Norman Rockwell. You guys probably know Norman Rockwell. He's amazing, like an old, he's dead as well, but it's like this amazing magazine illustrator. You know how in old times, like, most magazines would have picture painted?
Yeah, for ads.
Ads and things like that. He's an amazing draftsman and a painter as well. And so he was extremely, like many other people were at that time, inspired by Norman Rockwell. And he remembers specifically, like, looking for, and I'm paraphrasing here, like, he's looking for a foot reference. And the first thing he's going to do is grab Norman Rockwell books or magazines that he drew and, you know, look for foot reference. You know, I actually don't remember if it was an actual foot or not, but what I'm trying to say in the end is going to be the same. So he's looking for foot or grass. Sorry, it's not a foot. It was grass. He's looking for grass reference because he's drawing something that has grass.
Oh.
And then at one point, it just, like, an epiphany hits him, and he's like, you know what, I'm going to put this book down. He looks over the window, he's in front of the window, and he looks over the window, and there's grass, right?
Yeah.
And he just like an epiphany hit him, and he's like, you know what? I'm not gonna look at Norman Rockwell or anybody else. I'm gonna go outside, and I'm gonna draw this grass the way I think, or the way, you know, he's somehow influenced and he likes the grass to look like.
Yeah.
And since then, he says that he never really looked at any other artist in a copying way. And that's how he became super, super famous. That's how he became way better, by not copying other artists. He was still influenced by them. And yeah. I think that this is the hardest thing to kind of like describe or tell. There's a huge difference between being inspired by, and there's a huge difference between, you know, copying the artist. And I don't really know how to explain that myself, but you can divide both and still grow as an artist. The more you do things by yourself, better. Really. Like, it's, I don't know how to explain this. It's just how it is. And end of my rant.
That was a wonderful rant. You did really well.
Says here, I've eaten a reindeer.
Man, you've eaten a reindeer?
I haven't eaten a reindeer, but probably called venison. Venison.
Venison. I never ate venison. I
heard it's really, really fatty. But how about using a reference to compare your own work? Oh, no, Becky says it's lean. Oh, she's very lean. I'm sorry, I got it wrong. How about using a reference to compare your own work while you draw, so it would be easier to notice mistakes that haven't tested this theory yet?
Well, can you like, for the question for me? I don't.
How about using references to check your mistakes, basically?
That's what you do. Like, no. Like, references and artists are two different things. When you look at an artist looked at references. Who the hell knows that artists even looked at other artists? So mm-hmm. You're looking at an artist who maybe even looked at another artist, and who knows that other artists looked at another, you know how, where this goes, right?
Yeah.
So what you're taking distilled information that this person got from, and you're applying it to your own. You don't really learn as in, you might still learn, but you don't really learn as in depth as that person who did that painting learned.
Because they got it from the source.
Because they got it from the source. Now, when you look at reference such as, you know, photos, anything that's kind of, what do you call it? Like real. It doesn't even have to be real, because it's all subject to what you're trying to get better at. So, for example, design, you can take design influences from the real world, but there could be an artist out there who does really cool designs, and you can still learn something from them. But most likely, it would be better if you just take some pictures, go outside, whatever. Well, I don't want to advertise for you to go outside, because I don't go out much myself. But do whatever you can to take your information, your source information from the real world, mm-hmm. understand it, and then bend it. Basically, you know, make shit up. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Like, the way to learn is for you to fail. And that's kind of like a typical thing to say, but it really is like that. The only way for you to learn is for you to fail. It's for you to sketch and sketch and sketch and sketch and finish stuff as well, not just sketching. I see a lot of people just only doing sketches and not finishing stuff. And then when they try to finish something, it looks unfinished because they haven't practiced finishing, you know. But anyway, that's a different story. You have to keep on trying. You have to keep on trying to do something. For example, I was doing that hand, right? Yeah. I couldn't do the hand. I could have kept going, and most likely I would have kept going to actually make the freaking hand, but we're on the live stream, and I kind of like the Mega Man feel, like it's basic
a
cool cube.
It's a cool hand. It looked like he got his hand chopped off, and then he got fitted.
Yeah.
That's so cool.
But anyway, like, you keep failing. Sometimes, you know, maybe I actually prefer this kid without a hand, even though I should have fixed the hand, and I should have gone through it. Yeah. And sometimes you are surprised, you know. I can't tell you how many times I made a mistake on a painting, and that mistake was actually like a happy mistake.
Yeah,
You
yeah,
know?
yeah, yeah. Okay.
Like so many times, I might as well just know.
It's so funny because right now I'm using the same color to sketch with, and it was totally like accidental, like maybe subconsciously, but I was sketching this whole time, I think, with the same value and color as yours. Kind of like this burnt umber.
I really like that. Yeah, I tend to deviate from blacks unless.
Black, get it out.
What?
Get back in your cage.
What are you talking about?
No, Becky, she's watching stuff.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead. Burn umber.
Yeah, I like not using gray. Like the grays, I try to avoid them a little bit.
Yeah.
Although they're great as well, but they great. Get it?
They're great. They're so
great.
Yeah, they're so great.
They're so
cool. Oh, post a question. Why is John Silva too cool to hang out with us every once in a while?
I'm not.
Why are you too cool? Dude, you're on the other side of the world.
Yeah.
Hard.
It's like this that Jet has to wake up really early, or I have to wake up really early, and then Jet streams at night. So it's one way or another. And
yeah. Get on the chat. We're talking about Boogie Monster.
Yeah.
Talk about what?
No, it's funny. They know Becky's name. Her YouTube name, Boogie Monster.
Boogie Monster?
Thinking Becky this whole time, and they're like, Boogie Monster's Jet's future wife. I'm like, how did you stalk her?
How do you know? Damn.
Boogie Monster, Becky, same thing, same.
It's kind of creepy.
No, it's because I think last time she was on and we were, she's in the chat and we were all laughing about it. We're like, Boogie Monster, I know who you are.
Yeah, if you guys have any questions, feel free to interrupt me because I just keep on going. And
that's the best thing.
It's if you don't stop me, I'll.
You're like,
Jet will go to sleep and I'm still talking on his live stream. I mean.
Unlimited ammo. And that's the best thing in the video game. Unlimited ammo.
Yeah, I guess.
Heavy machine gun.
So yeah, that's the only reason why I don't hang out, because time zones are kind of weird and not always work out. Sometimes I'm just way too tired in the evening and just want to go and relax. Unless I wake up in the morning and we do this and like it's actually we actually set a date, then
yeah.
Do it.
Yeah, because we would meet really quickly, like, oh, he's going to bed and I'm just waking up. And then
just waking up, yeah.
We said, screw it, let's just set a date. And I'm actually going to set a date with Psychra too, so I made a date. I actually talked to him this morning. He's like, he said he was going to be back later in like a couple hours. So that's what Kosa just said too.
Okay. But
I was going to head out after this stream since I'm ignoring the Boogie Monster. You probably got to go to sleep soon. That drawing's looking great, by the way.
It's this is just a base. Like,
I love it.
At the moment, I'm figuring out what colors there is, and then I'll put in the colors, and then I would make the redo the line art to be a little thinner and add in some texture with it, which you know, still gonna be here a little bit.
Yeah, that would be cool if you could walk us through your process just a little bit. I keep having trouble with my nose. I'm trying to go for that super anime look, you know what I mean? But it's like it's hard to just settle with that just simple dotted nose, you know what I mean? Or like simple L nose, one of those.
Yeah.
I think that's fine. I think it was just too high. Anyways, yeah. So if you can just mention what you're doing as you go, that'd be cool.
What else?
What else? What else? What else? I like stuff. I like turtles.
I wonder if I should turn this into multiply. So yeah, like my painterly stuff, my illustration work, the way I'd go about it is exactly the same. I try to develop or kind of like meet halfway in terms of the way I paint, change one thing or two, so that whenever I'm doing comic stuff, it's the same as my illustration work. So in my illustration work, what I usually do when actually clients give me time, I'll draw a sketch like this, but in a realistic manner, not in a comic manner. And then I'll put in some flats underneath and then go over it and refine and make things look cleaner. And afterwards that, so I have underpainting and a clean line art. So I'll start painting over. And when I start painting over, you know, it's just like painting normally. I already have all the information I need. I already have all the information I need, and I'm just, I'll just keep painting.
Somebody asks, why does it keep switching? It switches because whoever's talking, it goes to. So, and they said it's annoying. I'm sorry that you're seeing the both of us at the same time.
I'm sorry. You're probably only seeing me because I'm talking all the time, so I should just...
No, we're switching because we're talking. So he's like, no. They said I should double screen it. How do I double screen? I don't think...
I know how to.
How?
I don't want to say it on live stream because everybody's going to do it. It's my little secret.
Okay, it's your secret, yeah. No, don't do it. Don't do it because we're doing it this way. We're doing it this way. We're doing it live.
Sakura knows how to because me and Sakura used to live stream really a lot. Me, Sakura.
That's kind of your origin. You kind of grew up with Sakura in the art, social art world.
Yeah, me and Sakura. We go like way. I'm hearing myself. I can't talk.
Oh shoot! You hearing yourself?
Let me turn it down. Sorry. Hold on. It's kind of like the speech jammer.
What? Hello?
Hello?
Okay, there you go. Can you hear yourself? Oh, shoot. You've been hearing yourself this whole time?
Some point, I started. Or maybe I just, some point, noticed I started listening to myself.
Okay, how about... Turn it down. Okay, say something.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
There you go.
Okay, yeah, I can't hear myself now.
Cool.
What was I saying? Oh, wait. My process? Is that it?
Do you want me to just read the comments for you?
That would be cool. Read my
what?
Because I'm not reading the comments either.
Shit, hold on a second.
I should have, because I said I would, but... let me open the comments as well. Who is talking? John Silva.
You read the comments.
For those asking for the Gumroad, he's doing it. He needs to voice. It's coming sometime this year. Oh, yeah, my Gumroad tutorial. Just like Jesso said, I need to do the voiceover. I have everything recorded, etc. I just need to do the voiceover, but I'm lazy. Kind of lazy. But I need to get that done at some point. But it's definitely coming this year. That's the thing.
Let me turn this thing down. Probably gonna go for another 30 minutes. Let's do another 30 minutes and then.
I'm gonna try to fill in the flats on the character. Yeah. See if I can do that.
I just want to do flat, simple shadows in this. Maybe not even shadows, just like specular highlights, and that's it. It's really, really simple.
I don't add anything. I just add flat, and that's it. I mean, usually just I'm skipping a step here. I would clean up my line art, and I like to do this kind of like hatching. It's not really hatching, but close to my really darks. I like to do this kind of hatching thing that's going to give me volume and acts almost as a shadow, and I just add in flat and that's it. Basically, I do this. Let me open one of my previous. So if you guys see these here, these are some of my these are some of my character exploration stuff here. That's exactly how I go about it. And yeah. I really like that look.
I really like that look. It's it's a style that I've seen a lot in comics. I mean, that's kind of really efficient for making it fast and also effective.
I just like the simple look. Yeah, it reminds me of the old stuff as well. So
yeah.
that's kind of what I'm going for. So I'm skipping the process of actually cleaning up the line art and then doing that kind of hatching and texture filling.
Does it say Becky? She said something about this boogie monster. Let's keep the boogie monster. Somebody said something about turtles. They're here. She's cracking up because she's like, I'm here because of turtles too, or something.
I could add some stuff.
Gosito 1000B.
Yeah.
He said, I'm here because.
Oh.
Reasons. I like turtles too.
Gosito 1000B. I'm here because reasons. I like turtles too. I like turtles. You know that kid?
Yeah, I do. Yeah, of course. Yeah.
I like turtles. A kid. No one asked you about turtles. The reporter was like,
back to you,
Joe. Yeah, reporter was freaked out, like, okay. It kind of scares me.
So, yeah. I don't know. I kind of ran out of things to say. If you guys have any specific questions about anything while I'm putting in the flats.
Yeah, guys, if you have questions, just type in questions before you write your question. It'll help us find your question easier. But there's a question that says here, Fernando Vega, what was it? What was the question? It disappeared, Becky. What was it? Say it, girl. If you're going to say it, you got to say it. All right, screw it then. I'll say it then.
Say it.
Says, what makes for a strong composition?
Strong composition? Yeah. Let me think about that before I... Okay, balance. Good balance. Strong compositional shapes. So you want big shapes. Mm-hmm. And you want to balance those shapes, right? Let's say... I like number three. So let's say you have three like big shapes in your composition. In my case here would be main character, little robot, and maybe the clouds would be the third one because there's a lot of it. There's a big shape of clouds right there. And then the fourth little details is just the kind of trees coming out of the... you know, into the sky, whatever. So that's kind of like the thing that I would consider having a strong composition. Aside from that, let me see.
How did you mention, I took a step out, did you mention a focal point?
Oh, and yeah, of course, focal point.
Yeah, focal point.
Well, you want to make sure that the focal point and the idea, they're very clear. That's a strong composition. When the idea is very clear, and that makes obviously the composition strong, then you have a successful composition. And the way to make it clear is by simplifying it, and you simplify it by putting in big shapes. You know, if you have like a character who's wounded and he's against the wall, like a brick wall, and you have a spotlight on the character, and you can add one more element to help the composition, but not overrun what you're trying to tell in the composition, the idea, you know? Maybe you could put like bullet shots, or maybe there's holes in the wall and you can see a little bit through the background. Like that's kind of like, it's simple, and then you use like little tiny details, but they're not overwhelming to the composition, to kind of spice it up, give it a flavor, you know.
Very well said. Very well said.
Thanks, man.
There's so much to composition.
There's really a lot, but that's kind of like the ABC of it.
Yeah. Oh, this is an exercise that we used in my color theory class, and that was just drawing random shapes.
Yeah, shoot. Definitely.
Sorry, drawing random shapes so that you know which shape you want to be the focus. So you don't even have to draw characters. You can just draw like circles and lines and kind of gesturing to show what you want to be the star of your drawing.
Yeah, exactly.
That was an exercise. Let's see what else we got here. Says draw Django.
Draw who?
Django. Do you Django? See the pit in your mind when you... Django. I don't know who Django is. Django from Django Unchained?
Yeah.
Wait, Django. Dango? I don't even know. Do you know?
Dango? No, I don't know what's Dango.
No. All right, moving on. There's a lot of questions now. Everyone's just question. Shoot. Costa says, did you mention where the focal point should fall into? The thirds. The thirds is the safest spot where I would choose, but it's not always the thirds. It can be center, it can be off thirds, but learning about your thirds and the golden ratio stuff will definitely help. And once you know what golden ratio is, then you can play around with how to trick the eye and,
yeah, exactly.
And not use the golden ratio. Yeah.
You don't have to. At one point, it becomes really boring when you're using that all the time in your paintings. It's like it becomes like, oh, while it works, it becomes boring.
Yeah. You know? There's okay, here's my like idea on it. For focal points, I mean, the rule of thirds and golden ratio thing, for me, it's good just generally, but if you want to send a message, a strong message, or some sort of statement, you can do things that are not golden ratio. For example, like if you just did like a center drawing or something was split half, like half and half, like two people facing each other like equally, or two people standing looking at each other equally, those are times where you can break it. Or like, what are those called? You do it for like newspapers and stuff, or there's a message you're trying to put out.
Yeah.
That's the times you would. I see.
I mean, composition can go really detailed, but personally, I like to simplify things and mess around with how simplified something is and move things around. You know, it doesn't have to be in like the golden rules, or so to say. Doesn't have to be that at all.
There's a lot of questions now. How do you figure out your color harmonies? Oh, Della Fast. Good to have you, buddy. That's so...
How do I... The color harmonies?
Harmonies, yeah.
Usually, I just kind of put down whatever colors I think would look good, and if they don't look good, in Photoshop there's this neat thing where I can called replace color. You can find it under adjustments, replace color. So here, and what does is you select like an area of colors, so it's very easy when you only have flats. So let's say I want to change this gun here. Actually, wait, before I change the gun, I need to only like slightly select this gun. Okay, so I have a selection, and I click on the gun, and I can change its color, as you can see. So I change that, and you can change its saturation and lightness. In the beginning stages of my painting, I discovered this, and I really, really like using it. So usually I have in my head kind of like, you know, complementary colors, like neighboring colors. They always work well. Complementary colors, they work well. So I don't really get into much color harmony, to be honest. I harmonize my colors with value. When I do normal paintings, mm-hmm. I use value to be the thing that's gonna harmonize my colors. So for example, I'll give you guys very, very quick example. Let's say I'm going to pick three colors, right? Oh, wait. I need to make a new layer. So at the top left, you got one color. And then I'm going to pick a neighbor color. Well, it's not really neighbor, but I'm going to pick another one. I got to make it darker, because you can't see it. So I have these three colors. I could use these three colors within, I don't know, let's pick the shirt of this character, for example. Let's do that. So let's pretend this is a painting that I want it to be like painterly, you know, just actual painting instead of flat shading. I'm going to pick the local color, which is this one. I'll put it here. The one that's apart from the other three. And I'm going to go to the same areas of green while still using a value relatively close to this shirt. I'll just go in and paint. So I got this color here. And then I can go in and choose, for example, the blue one, the same as that one. So select the local color, turn it into blue, make it like a value or two darker, and gently start putting it down. And I start merging those two colors together, right? So I can go here, maybe a little bit too strong, but I'll anyway apply it. So let's say we apply it over here, there, right? And then I start mixing in those two colors at some point. And because the value is very similar to one another, like when I put it black and white right now, you can't really tell, mm-hmm. right? Because the value is so close to one another, you can get away with whatever color you put in as much as, you know, at least more than if you put a value in there with completely different color, it's going to do too much of a big clash. And I can go with the orange again. Wait, select the local color, click on the orange, make it, let's see, how does it look like, the same value. I can even make it the same value, like I tap it very lightly so that there's a little opacity and the colors blend a little bit, and the values as well. And I can go in, and now we got like a multi-color. This is just an example, right? You don't want to really do this, but I'm just showing you that it's much more safe painting in colors that are close in value, even though they're so different from one another, rather than go there and be like, bam, let me paint green. Wait, I should do this on a different layer, so before and after. But yeah, like, bam, green. And then select another color and be like, oh, orange. But kind of, it's not orange anymore, it's like a peach color. Then blue for the shadows. Like, you know, he's going to look like a clown. But
that's perfect. I mean, that's a perfect analogy. You will look like a clown car.
Yeah. So even though this doesn't look very, very attractive either, but it's still very forgiving, all things considered. I have like three clashing colors, one next to another. And it still might look actually cool if I keep on rendering, if I keep on adjusting it, I can still try to make it cool. So that's it. That's how I go about color harmony. It's more about the value to me than the color itself, but you want to know the basics. You want to know the complementary, you know, colors that are neighbors and colors that they're on the other side of the color spectrum. That's really all I do. I don't go into tertiary colors. I don't even know tetraedic scheme. I don't even know the other names, to be honest.
That's crazy.
Tetraedic scheme, analogic scheme, accented, like none of this shit. I mean, honestly, I go by I and exploration. I know that neighbor colors, they work well. Colors that are on the other side of the spectrum, directly of the color spectrum, they work nicely for accents, and that's it. Everything else, I can put random colors as long as the value is correct, and it doesn't come off, you know, on your face too much. Don't let the colors come off on your face too much.
What?
That's what I said.
Don't let the colors come off your face too much.
But, yeah, so right now, see, as I had, like, purple kind of, like, shoulder plates and the shooting cannon thing on his hand was the same color, and I just really quickly adjusted that. No, I want them to be the same value. What else?
Well, what else? See. What else we got, people? What are the questions? You got a lot of questions. Question. How do I question? You did it right.
You do it exactly like that.
Yeah, it's just like
Oh, I have one thing to add.
Yeah, no, keep going.
To the color harmony that I just reminded now because I'm doing that right now. You want to keep as minimal of group colors as you can. And I mean, like, this character, I try to let him have only, like, three main different colors, for example, not counting with his skin. So I would have the red cape, the gray for the shoulder pads, and maybe like he would have something on his other arm that's gray as well, and then green. Now, a cool trick is that you can use neighboring greens. For example, I use his shirt and his pants are a different green, but they're still green. So I try to keep it grouped. I think that's the correct word. I try to keep it grouped. The color is grouped, and I try to put it as minimal as possible. And then I can go in later on and add, like, little hue shifts, you know, like little color shifts, and make spice things a little bit, add a little bit of salt and pepper, then eat your painting. What else do I do? Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Okay. I'm just checking to see if they're seeing your screen or my screen. Yeah, it's I just wonder if it's like switching between us even if I'm not saying anything, and it's not. So we're good on that. What do you recommend someone who has done a ton of figure drawings and portraits and now wants to do backgrounds?
I want to make this kid blue, maybe.
That is a hard one.
What?
Me, because I'm in the same kind of boat. So someone who does a ton of figures and they want to start doing backgrounds.
Easy. Just do a ton of backgrounds. as someone who wasn't doing many backgrounds and was only doing character work, and the more I keep going, I do more and more, like add a lot more of environment to my characters. It's only by doing it, really. Like, you can still apply the same things. There is a sense of gesture in the environments. There's a sense of flow in the environments, which can be tied up with the composition, right? But environments is a lot more structural than and less forgiving than actual, life drawing / characters. There's a lot more hard surfaces. There's a lot more geometrical shapes. I'm just gonna merge these two together. There's a lot more geometrical shapes, while the body only has like a few. I think you can even lower the body, the geometric shapes, like four basic geometric shapes for the body, and you're good to go for anatomy. Environment has a lot more. Environment is a lot more triangular That's one thing I noticed the more I keep doing environments. There's a lot of triangle shapes. So do studies. Analyze things by yourself. What?
Triangles, huh?
Yeah, there's a lot of triangular shapes to the environments. Look at mountains, for example. Look at rocks. It's very edgy, you know? Look at buildings. Very edgy.
True. Trees.
Trees. Very edgy.
Yeah, I still have trouble with backgrounds.
Although trees are more on the organic side, but still part of the environment. One huge thing. Yeah, pine trees. Yeah. One huge thing I can tell you is I forgot because I was thinking about something else.
It's the biggest one.
It's the biggest one, and I forgot. So there you go. Let me see. Oh, proportion. That is the biggest thing about the environment. When you do a character, you're so used to seeing things up close, you know, and like it's one thing. It's not influencing, like, a character is only influencing itself, nothing else. So you only have to worry about things within the character. But in environment, everything influences each other. So my recommendation for you is do a lot of studies, do a lot of environment studies, but focus on the geometric shapes and the relation between another, aka perspective and proportion. So that's what you really want to focus on to tell a believable, to paint a believable environment. Proportion to one another and perspective is number one, like number one priority to me. Yeah. I might be wrong, but when I do paint and stuff, that's what I focus on, and that's what I usually have more success on. Because you can actually paint a beautiful scenery, but like the trees look way too big or way too thick, then like the pebbles, they look, you know, maybe really big as well in comparison to the tree. Like everything is comparable, and you have so many elements within one environment, then it can be a little bit overwhelming. So that's why you do studies, to be accustomed to what size one thing is in comparison to another. Boom! Science,
bitch. They said I deselected you.
It's okay. I'm not showing anything. So, I mean,
I think it went back to you, yeah.
But,
let me know if it's gone back. From that, I'm going to read some more comments.
I'm nearly done with the flats, so.
It's still switching, Jet. All right, let's stick to John, then.
No, you don't have to.
Okay. Jet, watch back. Okay. Hey, what's up, Artist Journal? What's up, girl? Hey, yo, what's up, girl?
Looking fine today, girl.
I want your Starbucks, girl.
This shit. So, any more questions or...
Question. What do you consider when you are working on rendering a form?
The form. I'm considering the form. When I'm rendering form, I'm only considering about the form. You know those 3D wireframes you see a lot in 3D stuff, right? Think about it like that. Like a cross contouring of whatever shape or form you're drawing. For example, I really like doing this exercise as a warm up. So if I draw a cylinder here at the top, right, I can draw it like this as accurately as I possibly can, and then I cross contour it I'll draw it with red, or kind of like orange, to be honest. But I like doing this, and then, of course, not as fast as I'm doing. I actually think about every single stroke of cross. Whatever word I said before, and I already forgot. And I actually really think about the placement of those and how it would, how does it affect my shape? And then I can do it here with blue, and go the other way. No, not blue, because the sky is blue. So I'll do it pink, and then go the other way. And really think about it. Don't do it fast. Don't do it anything, and then. Because then you'll just screw it up because you're not thinking about it. You're just guessing. You're not really trying your best to think about it. So, you know, like this. You have this cylinder, and then I'll just do it in different colors so that you can see how I would go about it. And then the more the shape gets complex, then, you know, the slower I'm going to go. And you know, those do that little cross-contouring.
How do you become like Kim Jong-gi?
You draw a lot. Yeah, like, you draw everything a lot.
Yeah.
And you study a lot. You think, what, he's just... I'm sure by now he just looks at things and he has amazing memory. If you can do exercises for memory... Even things that don't actually matter in drawing or illustration, for example, puzzles, you know, or anything that challenges your brain for memory, like there's those kinds of puzzles, like, oh, see what's wrong in the picture, and then there's like two pictures.
Yeah.
You know, any kind of exercise that improves your memory, your long-term memory. It's going to help you in art. I used to forget things a lot more. And the more I actually try to remember things and do like little exercises, and like I would look at the picture and then I would hide it and then I would draw it. And I would bring the picture back again. And I'm like, oh, looks like crap. Looks nothing like that thing. And I would keep doing on the same picture over and over again until I was like as accurate as possible.
I don't know if people know this, but yeah, Kim Jong-gi studied a lot of pictures from like magazines, and everything he saw, he would just draw it over and over.
He still does that. That's the thing. People, he gets so good because he doesn't stop. What usually happens with professional, you know, illustrators, comic artists, whatever, once they get really good, they stop exercising. And he does a ton of sketches every single day. I know that for a fact. And he teaches, so even more. He has to force himself to learn even more so that he can teach others. So whenever you do a study, study it in a way as if you'd had to teach it to someone else. Can you teach that thing? Then you did the study successfully. If you can't, then you suck. You need to redo it again until you finally don't suck. Because... like Jake said in, Jake said to Flynn, you only get good at something by sucking at something. So
Adventure Time.
Adventure Time, yeah.
Oh snap!
And he's right.
Like Jake, his name is Jet. No.
Like what are you saying? That's not my name.
Okay. Okay, that's a good response to Kim Jong-gi. You know, I wasn't actually gonna like respond seriously, but that's really good insight.
Well, if someone asks me something, I might as well just respond seriously.
Yeah.
Or what I think, at least.
There's so many people on the show. You guys are still sticking around? Goodness gracious.
Art of Jizzle, has any of you worked on advertising jobs? If you have, how do you like it? I heard there's a ton of money in advertising.
Oh, there's a ton of money in advertising. Yeah.
Well, I think art in general is pretty much advertising. You're advertising the game with your art.
Yeah. But when you do art specifically for advertising,
yeah,
you get a lot of money as well.
Yeah.
While pre-production stuff gives you a lot of money as well, but it's more of throughout time, a lot of money, not just, yeah, bam, here's $1 million. No, that would be nice. But I'm actually super rich, but people don't know.
Yeah, he's just rich. That's how he's able to do all this. It's the money. Money does everything for you.
Money does everything. I got good because I got money.
Because you got money. Damn those rich people.
That's how things work.
So get rich first and then get good.
Yeah.
Duh.
Exactly. What is this? The trees? Okay. I got my little flats here. This is a horrible canvas size. It's like a square, but who cares? Who cares? Do you do any sports, Jet?
I only did I used to play a lot of basketball, but in high school I did wrestling.
Oh shit! You did wrestling?
I did wrestling because I was always doing martial arts. I did karate, taekwondo. I did some Thai kickboxing. I did some Aikido. You know Aikido?
Yeah, of course I have done.
Yeah, I did a lot of Aikido, and that was funny because I didn't know anything about Aikido. I didn't even know Steven Seagal did Aikido, and I got put into Aikido, and I was just like, "This is lame." But then I found out later, it's powerful. It's great. It's really good. It's one of my favorites.
Yeah.
And then I did wrestling in high school because it's more contact sport.
Oh, you love feeling other people.
Yeah. I love feeling people. Oh. Love that contact.
It's like, hey, what's up, man? Just feel them.
Hey, man, time to feel.
Time to feel.
Yeah. Every time I hit the mat, I'm like, feeling time, guys. Feeling time. Let's feel.
Let's feel together.
Time to feel.
Let's do it.
Here, feel me. I'll feel you.
Feel me? Yeah. I feel you.
Feel me? That's where it came from. You feel me?
Yeah.
Sure.
Comes.
Yeah.
Feeling.
How are you doing, John? You ending it soon?
Oh, this can go on forever, but the basic flat colors are done. And then I like to add in some little, like, shapes, like different colored shapes to whatever I'm painting. So it only, like, evolves from this point on. This is, like, as basic as it gets, and then I can change the clouds color. Actually, I want them to be more blue. Like this, so that the character clashes a little bit more against the background. Before, it was blending a little bit too much. So, especially with his skin tone. let me see how you're drawing, because
just
looking at the chat.
I'm going really slow because this desktop can't handle sharing. At the same time, I'm not used to this.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
This keyboard. Cool. I haven't used my Mac keyboard for like a year, and I'm just getting used to this the keys layout again, and the Manga Studios. Everything is just all off from my settings, so I'm like super slow. I'm sorry, John.
I'm so sorry.
I'm so slow.
No, it's okay, man. Don't worry about it. Could add some stuff. Could add some lighting to my character. Real quick lighting.
Yeah, real quick lighting, and call it a day. Call it a day. Jet, you just deselect. Oh, that's old. Watch it back. Okay, Illuminati. Whoa! Oh, for lucky charms. Is it on YouTube? The ad. Whoa, your mic turned weird for a second, John. In your about section, there is nothing checked being checking each of you guys since the stream began. Creep, wink.
What? Huh? There's nothing about my...
There's his Tumblr on there. In this about... Well, this
Oh, there's nothing on my about in the Tumblr? Is that it?
No. The description has your Tumblr, I think. It's a little about section. There's nothing checked. Been checking each of you guys since the stream began. Creepy wing. I don't know. Checking them out. Maybe they're talking about something else. Oh, I think they're talking about their DeviantArts.
Okay.
I don't know. But Jet did man wrestling. Okay, here's the thing. I gotta tell my story, all right? This is going out to all you people. If from high school, you guys are watching and we wrestled. Let me tell you the truth about wrestling, man. I'll tell you how good I was in wrestling. I kicked ass, man. I gotta tell you, I kicked ass in wrestling. And the thing about it was, I sucked at the tournaments, but I kicked our teammates' ass. And our school was like the top school in the like freaking nation. We went pretty far, but anyways,
the whole nation, damn.
Yeah, the whole nation. The thing about me, I was always really good at practice, but then when it came to tournaments, I was always like a pound or two overweight. And the thing about wrestling is you can't wrestle if you're wrestling team can't wrestle if you don't make weight. If one of you guys don't make the weight you need to be at, then the whole team doesn't wrestle. So I was always like forced to like run before the matches and then before the tournament. I'd like they'd put like 10 sweaters on me and then make me run outside, and I'd lose the weight every time. But guess what happens?
You're tired.
I'm tired. I'm drained, and I have no energy to fight. I did like mediocre during wrestling, but man, during the
okay, man, practice, we understand. Don't worry.
People were just like in practice, like, yeah, what happened, man? You're kicking our asses, but they're using them.
You were the Asian Hulk Hogan back then.
The Hulk Hogan.
Yeah, Hulk Hogan.
Yeah.
I usually don't add lighting to my characters, but I thought this time I'll do it.
I don't like this lighting.
You don't like my lighting?
No, I like your lighting. You're fine. No.
I'm fine, thank you. I've been working out, you know. It's,
you know. I noticed. Actually, I haven't even seen you. Yeah.
You haven't ever seen me?
No, I've seen you.
No, you've seen me, right? Yeah. I put a camera once or something.
You put it up. John's a model, you guys. You lived in Japan, and people just stop you all the time to try to take your picture.
It was something like that, yeah. Funny story, though. When I actually... Last time I went to Japan, when I stayed there for... almost a year. When me and my girl we were coming out of the what do you call it? Is it the runway in the airport? I don't know. It's, you know, you just go out. You have your bag. You got all your luggage, everything. You're coming out, and then there's always like a bunch of people waiting at the front.
Yeah.
For the people who arrived, right? Yeah. You get what I'm saying? Am I explaining myself properly?
Yeah.
So at this particular day, for some reason, it seems like someone important was coming, and there was a bunch of cameras. And I mean, like, I don't know, at least three to four different TV stations in there. So like somebody pretty big must be coming. And my first instinct was to pretend I am that person. So I started waving at the cameras. They started rolling. They started coming closer to me, and I'm waving like I'm trying
to
be.
I'm getting called on Google Hangout. Oh shit! Come on, I'm hanging up. Costa, is that you, man? Anyways, continue. Yeah. So they okay. Yeah. What? They started waving at you?
No. I started waving. Like waving to the cameras. I started waving to the cameras, pretending I'm the guy they're waiting for.
So you intentionally knew. You're like, okay, it's time to put on the show. He said, I'm gonna pretend.
I just told my girl, like, watch this. And then like I put my arm around her, and I'm just like waving and walking, you know, confidently as much as I can. And they started like rolling and stuff like this. And it was really funny, because they're gonna start coming towards me with the microphones. And then the other cameraman started saying, no, that's not him. That's not... Oh, man, it was really funny. And then they started looking at me like weird. They're like, that's right, bitches.
That's cool. It's not me. That's cool.
It was really funny. It was really fun. I usually don't do that kind of stuff, but I was like, I was in the mood, I guess, or something.
Yeah.
He was really, and especially because my fiance, she's really shy. Like, especially camera wise, it's like the ultimate camera shyness. So it was a little bit of a tease as well. But it was really funny back then. Like, can you imagine Japanese be like, and then the confusion faces.
Like, you guys don't even know who you're trying to film. What's wrong with
you? Exactly. I was like, you don't know how the person who's about to come looks.
It's so
like.
Funny. Maybe they just change the direction. Like, we know who we want. But this guy, he's out now, and he's big. He's somebody big. Can you not tell? Let's get him now and worry about the other person later.
Yeah. It was really funny.
Anyways, looks like I'm going to call this drawing quits, because this drawing's...
Yeah, we've been on for some time now.
Not filming it too much.
At this point, honestly, I don't usually add highlights and stuff to my characters, but I felt like I wanted to this time. But this is my Alchemy Rush kind of my comic style process. It's the same as painting, really. Like, if this were a painting, then I would just make a new layer on top, go in here, and then start adding. Maybe use the line art as a shadow, and I would start painting over the lines and fixing everything. So it would start coming out. Actually, I have one before we go. I have one.
Please do.
I have one I did 2 days ago or whatever. I started do this kind of thing on a comic kind of character. If my Photoshop will open it.
Yeah,
now we have to wait.
Mine is so laggy. It's so slow on this desktop.
Mine is because I didn't drew today. Didn't drew? Is that?
Yeah,
is that correct?
That works. I didn't drew all the time.
Yeah, I didn't drew all the time. I didn't draw today.
Yeah.
So every time I just open one file for the first time, then it lags. But you have basically I did the same. Oops, I did the same on this character. I was just testing this, not. You know, from my comic or anything, but you can see some of the line art here at the bottom. I did exactly the same line arts, flat colors, and then start painting on top. I could do exactly the same on this character. I actually like the colors. I actually like the highlight thing. Maybe not on the background too much, but that's it, guys.
It was looking good. Yet don't be done. The scalp was. You guys are still seeing me? I thought we clicked onto John. What the hell?
They didn't see the picture? Or what?
I'm going to you, man. What the hell? That is looking great, dude. Really, really popping the lights. No, now it's switching. Okay. Yeah, dude.
Wait,
I love the circle greens that you have on his sweater.
Oh, yeah. I like adding
some detail. I think maybe see some more of that so they know like that's those are actually circles. Maybe like a full circle somewhere. Maybe just so that we can see that's the design.
Okay. I can put one on his crotch. Wait.
Oh yeah, on his crotch, of course.
Always on his crotch. Wait.
Always.
I actually prefer half circles over full circles.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
That's what half circles. But I can put one here. You know, some pants have like that, like old.
I do know.
Just peed himself. I'll add some more somewhere else so that it doesn't look like he just peed.
Now if
he would see the whole character, maybe he would have some on his knees as well.
Yeah.
So he looks like he's kind of flying with his buddy, whatever. I would make this canvas. Narrower and longer so that we could tell what the hell is going on. Like, are they on top of something? In this case, I could add really quickly. It's wrong color. could add really quickly just like some grass, so maybe they're actually standing on grass, but this grass would have to be blue because we have too much green going on. So I don't know, like, you have to stop me because I'll just keep going forever.
Keep going.
So I can just add really...
People are actually saying, don't go yet. I'm like, really? It's been like 3 hours.
Has it been 3 hours? Like, really? 3 hours? Damn.
Yeah, I think so. It's one by fast, huh?
Yeah. Well, you started at 7, 8, 9, 2 hours and a half, yeah.
Yeah.
So I'd add in some kind of... Since we can see the rest of the painting, I just add some kind of grass or whatever. It could be grass, it could be rocks. Maybe rocks would work better here, because grass this high is not common. But hey, it's a comic. We can do whatever the hell we want. If we want grass in there, could make these characters' hair grass. Who cares? Right? And that's the good thing about it. But anyway, I am myself done. Because I'm just going to keep going forever.
Okay, let me switch over to mine real quick and then finish this. I think I just need to change the... Hello?
I'm listening, yeah.
Okay. Sometimes it just like goes really silent. I think maybe...
Really silent, yeah. I think my microphone, if I keep quiet, it kind of mutes himself. Like which the noise suppression. I have not a very known one. It's a Gambird, G-E-M bird, whatever. But it's really good.
It's Gambird.
Gambird.
I'm using a Yeti. You know the Yeti.
Yeah, I know. Those are like the expensive ones.
Matter of fact, Boogie Monster got me that too. She gave me everything. She got me Manga Studio too.
Oh, damn. All time.
Supportive, man. She supports my art.
Yeah, man. That's right. You're lucky.
Did I tell you I got a Cintiq?
You got a Cintiq? Nice, yeah. Man. Nice.
She got it for me.
I'm gonna buy one. Again. Sponsored.
Crazy.
It's
crazy like that.
You like it? Which one is it? Cintiq Companion?
13-inch. Oh, I like it. I've been using it for the past month, and now I'm like finally going back to my drawing pad, and it feels weird. It's weird.
I really want to buy one, but yeah. I can't until I move to my permanent apartment.
Huh?
Because I'm not gonna carry it. You know, yeah. I'm lazy like that.
So are you gonna get a big one?
I'm gonna get a big one, the 27, yeah. And also I'm gonna get a companion.
Oh, that too.
An electronic companion. I have a real companion, but I need the electronic one.
It's so funny. I remember, okay, I mentioned the Cintiq real quick before my birthday, and then Becky came out of the car with the box from my present, and then I was like, oh, no. I can tell already about the size. You got me a companion, didn't? And she's just like confused. She's like, what are you talking about? I got you a person? She thought I was joking. Like, really? And I looked at her just, really?
Those blow-up dolls.
Blow-up doll. Right.
Got me a companion. Yeah, no, man. Becky doesn't do art, right? What do you do, Becky?
Becky, what do you do, Becky?
What do you do, Becky?
I'm an ordinary person.
I don't think they could hear you.
I couldn't hear. Yeah, I couldn't hear very well what you said.
I'm an ordinary person.
She's an ordinary person.
Oh, you're an ordinary person. You're one of those. God damn it.
I have an 8-to-5 job.
Where?
Hello personal on the internet.
Oh, what? I'm sorry. I forgot we're on the internet.
You don't have to, but if you want
it. No. It's okay. Keep it for yourself.
It's so funny.
No. I can be rude like that too.
She's very professional. She's in the businesses. No, not the business.
Okay, I'll ask you this. Do you like what you do?
Yes and no.
Okay. I won't get more into detail. However, I am curious why yes and no.
We can discuss that later.
Later.
hey, Tina Hidarimigi.
She's not here. You're lucky. But she would answer. She doesn't fucking care.
Honestly. Yeah, I heard her. I heard her cough a little bit earlier. I was like, so funny.
Oh, she was laughing her ass off. Yeah.
She was?
Yeah. She does nothing. She does nothing. She's becoming artists. Ongoing artists. And she just started as well. Aside from that, she was doing nothing. Aside from supporting me, I guess.
Yeah.
That's more than enough, man.
That's the best.
That's how I pay her. I pay her for the mental support.
Yeah, you need that mental support. They say, like, with behind every powerful
man, there's a powerful woman.
Yeah,
vice versa.
There's a supportive girl or
something like that.
Yeah, something like that.
But we don't want to make you. We don't want to belittle you. You don't have to support anybody. You can be the one being supported. I wish I could be doing nothing and just support my fiance. I can't wait until she's good enough and I'll just grind on her. I mean, you know, work wise as well as. I guess it's no.
Just straight up grind on her like that.
Just straight up be like, oh, you're working? Not anymore.
Grinding time. How do you like that? Grinding.
But yeah, I can't wait to be the one not doing anything and just be like, yep, pay for me.
Yeah. it's kind of reversed right now. I'm waiting for that moment where I can just like force her out of her job. If I become big enough.
I mean, honestly, I heard her talking.
No, she said, I don't want to. She says she likes to work. Anyways.
You like to work. The independence. Yeah, that's good. You should do your own thing, regardless of monetary reasons or not. Like, a lot of times it's not about monetary reasons. It's not about money.
Yeah.
The fact that you have something for yourself and you can call it your own, even if it's a little, you know, you could be a millionaire. For example, I always said to Tina that, you know, she doesn't have to work, and she really doesn't.
Yeah.
She doesn't have to work and stuff, but she wants to have her own job, of course, and I really support that because I know how it is. You know, even though it gets old, in the beginning it's okay, but then it gets old, and you kind of get bored as well. Like, she becomes really bored, especially when she's done with her things and she's waiting for me, and it can become quite bothersome, especially that we don't have friends here because we live in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah.
And
so funny. And, same over here. We're kind of just lonesome.
We need a couple
to hang out with.
Right. You need a Portuguese and Polish couple.
Yeah, you don't want to make anyone feel like third wheel. That's why it's hard to be just, you know. So you got
to
find a
Yeah, that's true. It's hard to find people who are okay being with couples. Although whenever we are with friends, we try to you know, not smooch, not grind on each other live.
We don't want to grind on each other too much.
Yeah, too much in front of other people. But yeah. I'd like to think we're a cool couple. Even to just single friends.
Can you help my mom? She needs help.
What?
YouTube.
I don't know how to fix
it. Go fix it. I'm ending the show. Show's ending. Such a strange show, isn't it? People just draw and you guys watch.
Yeah.
Us draw and we just talk about random stuff. It's Did you envision yourself at your point right now, like 10 years ago? How about five years ago?
Not even 5 years ago.
Wow.
No, I mean, I started painting 4 years ago.
Wow, really?
I just told
you. No, I know that part, but I'm saying you didn't see yourself.
No, not at all. I was 100% sure I'm going to be a musician.
Dang.
Like 100% sure. There was no other way. And then, bam, there was another way.
Yeah.
Fuck. Fuck me, I guess, right?
Yeah, I guess.
I guess.
Or grind on you. Either one.
Grind on me.
Grind on you. Oh, no, shit. Not really. I don't know about doing that to you.
No, don't do that to me.
I won't do it. I'm not.
Please.
Because I'm happy the way I am.
Yeah.
I have something to grind on already.
Okay, so are we finishing these or what?
Yeah, we're finishing it. All right. All right, guys. Thanks so much for watching. And thanks for joining the show, John Silva.
Thanks for having me. Jerry Jet Show.
Wait, this is my name is the Jerry Jet Show, and this is John Silva.
And this is the John Silva.
I'll put all the links below. We're going to put his Tumblr, his DeviantArt, everything, these streams and all that stuff.
Everything.
As you guys can tell, full of insight, and he's unlimited ammo. So if you guys want to check out his stuff, go right on over there. Oh, and you got a YouTube, right?
I have a YouTube. People subscribe to me for no absolute reason because I don't have videos yet. But if you want to do that, I will at some point.
He'll get videos someday. He'll be a YouTuber.
Unless I decide to live stream on YouTube, but I still feel weird about that. I don't know how you do it.
Yeah.
He's not good material.
What?
Because it's just me. Like, I'm not doing anything. Like, why would people watch these? But I don't know. I feel like I would want to use YouTube just as a... tutorials and things.
Just to do it. Just to have it.
I don't know. Maybe I'll change my mind. I change my mind every second, so.
Yeah. All right, man.
So, yeah, thanks. Fun. Thanks for having me.
Thanks a lot, everybody.
Thank you guys for coming as well. It's really fun. Maybe we'll do this again.
Yes, they're saying, get John on again. Bye, John. Get John on the stream. Later. Kelsey Gilman, good to have you. Straight out shout out to you. That's right. You're the lucky shout out, Kelsey Gilman. Give it up to Chelsea.
Who's that?
I don't know. Random person on the screen. Thanks for joining, Kelsey, and everybody else. Till next time. You guys keep drawing. This is the Jetty Jet Shazam. Talk to you guys later.
Oh, I live stream as well.
Before. And he live streams as well on his live stream. We'll get the link on there.
It's just the live stream.
The Dower.